Andrew Lloyd Webber, the most powerful man in musicals, is putting his money and reputation on the line.
I mean, what's £4 million and my reputation? Of course I'm worried.
In the biggest risk of his career so far, he's decided to cast the lead role in his stage version of The Sound of Music with a complete unknown.
Next.
And even more intriguing, and some might say insane, the man who normally retains 100% control of everything he does...
No.
Fine.
...is letting you, the British public, decide who gets the coveted role. Playing Maria Von Trapp live every night for 6 months to an audience of 2,000 people.
And I can say with utmost certainty that one of you is Maria.
Lloyd Webber is a very busy man. With 3 shows opening across the world virtually back to back, he's appointed a panel to find his Maria. His co-producer of The Sound of Music, David Ian.
No, I'm sorry, it didn't do it for me. I'm not going to put you through.
Next. Vocal coach, Zoe Tyler.
I can feel the testosterone sitting here, it's like it's going crazy.
And mercurial leading man, John Barrowman.
Expressions that when you sing, there's some facial things going on that aren't so nice to look at.
They've whittled 6,000 hopefuls down to a shortlist of 50 who could be Maria.
Gosh, I think there's a couple of window panes just gone here.
But despite his overwhelming workload, Andrew's interfered every step of the way.
The whole a little samey. I'd just like to have one more trawl. I'm sure in there is my Maria. I'm sure of it.
He's not convinced the panel have chosen the right girls to go forward for intensive vocal and acting training. What he's called Maria School.
Good morning, girls.
Morning.
Welcome to Maria School. Over the next 3 days, the tutors and David and I will be monitoring you extremely closely. We want to see passion, we want to see spirit, we want to see dedication. Do not let yourselves down.
But unbeknownst to everyone at Maria School, including Zoe, the man who's put his money and reputation on the line is on his way over, ready to drop a bombshell.
If you make it through Maria School, you'll be given the chance to perform live in front of Lord Andrew Lloyd Webber at the end of the week.
In fact, they're going to see him a lot sooner than that. In his quest to find the perfect Maria, Andrew's about to make everybody's life much harder.
Now, do people know you're showing up today?
No, they don't.
Right, so why are you here?
Because I thought I'd have a good look at things. I want to spy on the whole activities.
Right, and I hear a rumour that you've brought some extra Marias.
Yeah, I looked at all the tapes of all the girls, and I thought there were a few who were quite good. In fact, very good. But I thought 4 were excellent who were missed.
And do you think this is going to freak out the panel?
Well, it may do, it may not. Hopefully it will.
Be punctual and professional at all times.
Andrew's impromptu arrival catches Zoe completely unawares. It's a shock for everyone. But the biggest surprise he is yet to deliver.
Good morning, girls, and welcome. I'm here just to wish you all the very, very best of luck. And to say one thing, I've seen the tapes of all of you, the videotapes. I've obviously not seen you live. I thought that, if I was going to be quite honest, that there were probably 6 of you who really could really hack it. Really, I thought. I thought we'd perhaps missed 4 who I thought possibly should be among you. And I brought those 4 with me today. So first of all, I brought Lucy with me.
Spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down. The medicine go down, medicine go down.
I think you're a bit posh. I think you're lovely.
Okay.
You're not Maria.
She's very pretty. slightly baffled why she didn't go through. The second girl I decided to save is Rianne.
She's dire, gotta say.
She's got absolutely everything, hasn't she? Except she's completely untrained. Closely followed by Kimberly.
Fish gotta swim and birds gotta fly. I've got to love one man till I die.
I've rejected better people than you today.
She's overcome with nerves, but she's a babe and wouldn't completely say no to her. And last but not least, the irrepressible Kirsty.
Papa, papa, that's how it goes. Papa, everyone knows. They all suppose what they want to suppose when they hear papa.
Why is it that I think there's a spark there? Perhaps it's because of my thought about Maria being this little tomboy.
Do you honestly think that you are Maria and you can hold that show every single night?
She is the kind of girl you'd absolutely believe could climb up a tree. I get all that from her. I really get that.
You're not Maria.
I was horrified when I saw that Kirsty had been saved. Because for me, she doesn't act like a singer. She doesn't sing like a singer. She's got so much work to do. So much work to do on every area of being on the stage.
For the 51 girls originally picked, their exclusive world has come crashing down.
Do we even stand a chance now? He's already picked
He's
who he likes.
Why
are we even here? And his other comment about, there's only about a dozen of you that I would have picked. I wonder who the dozen are.
With his West End premiere of Evita looming, Andrew heads off to tackle his problems there. He leaves singing coach Zoe Tyler in charge.
It's about being in control of your larynx.
She's been at the top of her field for over a decade, performing with Elton John and coaching more than 55 West End stars.
Do it again one more time.
Zoe knows playing Maria is the biggest job in show business. And with only 20 girls allowed through this week, she's taking no prisoners.
You know, it's tough at showbiz. They've got to be pushed. From being tough, we'll be able to see who's got the potential.
OK, off we go. OK, stop. You know what? She's like that. Gormless.
Even golden girl Siobhan, so impressive last week, is starting to unravel.
She's going to Maria.
Show through!
I can't control my voice. Last night I was sitting down at dinner and I completely lost my voice, which was nice, which kind of scared me, and it was still the same this morning.
The pressure has overwhelmed Siobhan as her voice and then her confidence completely deserts her.
I was actually sick, which is the reason why I ended up crying, because it kind of took me by surprise.
Let it go.
That's it. Okay, just do your best.
Right? Just do your best. Breathe. Come on.
And I don't know why I was sick, it's probably just the nerves.
I should think Siobhan is beautiful, she's got star quality. She's having vocal problems, and I think it's obviously knocked her confidence. She really needs to pull her socks up and show me that she's as good as she was in the audition. I can't see that right now.
And with girls like classically trained Emily in her class, she's got a long way to go if she wants to survive the week. Siobhan is most definitely not the only one struggling. 28-year-old actress Simona has a unique vocal problem of a different kind.
Oh,
There's an accent there. Where are you from?
Originally, I am Romanian.
Certainties disappear. What do we do for our dream to survive? How do we keep our passions alive? As we used to do.
I've got to be honest with you, Simona.
It's concerning
only
both of us.
Only for the purposes of this part,
yes.
You do have, understandably, a Romanian accent.
Yes.
Simona, this one, I'm afraid, is really, really tough for me. I worry that you won't be able to lose that accent. I worry that it's not right for the part of Maria.
David, come on, we're supposed to be the European Union now.
She'll
come
work.
On.
You'll work. Look at her. She'll work.
And there's great parts out there that wouldn't be a problem for that.
Do you know, I'm here for 4 years and a half and my accent has been such a big problem.
I know, darling, I know.
Do you reckon that you could lose that accent?
Yes, I can.
You think you should go to Maria's school?
If I can sing, I can lose that. Yes.
Stop crying. Stop crying. I'm going to give you a chance. I'm going to put you through.
Thank you very much.
You could be Maria.
He had it coming. He had it coming.
So, Simona is in. Two other girls who only got through by the skin of their teeth are saved girl Kirsty and 17-year-old Bryony. Their appeal wasn't their singing prowess, but their Maria-esque personalities.
Can you feel the back of your throat?
We're quite similar in lots of ways.
So what are your similarities?
That we both really like children, and she sings outside, and I often sing when I'm walking down to work, and she fancies Christo a plumber, and so do I, a lot.
All admirable qualities in Maria. None come nanny who wins the heart of a captain. But without the basic performance tools, no Maria here is going to be winning the heart of anyone, least of all Zoe.
You're flat as pancakes! Stop. What was wrong with that? Apart from everything.
The high note. It was getting up to that high part. It's from. See, it's going up and then coming back down and then going up and then coming back down again.
It's called singing, babe.
I know.
So you both need to go away and have a little chat. Breath. Just notes, love. Get over there. Go in the garden for 10 minutes, sort it out. If you can't hear your singing out of tune, there's not much I can do. There's not much I can do with that vocally, I'm afraid. See that it's down?
Yeah.
Do it.
Oh.
Lower. Drop your throat lower. Now quieter. Oh. Are you going to be sick? Yeah? Quiet, go.
Pia.
No. See the breaths there, you're going. Okay. Okay, it's not happening. I haven't got time. Okay, so just do the best you can. Okay, here we go. In twos. One, two. Pair off.
With time ticking away, Kirsty has one more chance to show Zoe she has what it takes. Andrew's co-producer, David Ian, will be here to eliminate 15 girls from Maria School. Kirsty may be the first in line.
Okay. Do you know what? It's like a knife, all that flatness going on. Okay, the garden didn't help.
Whenever I first came into her class, I was expecting someone, like, she's the teacher, we are there to be taught, right? So far, the only lesson I've learnt about myself is apparently I don't even use bad words. I've never, ever, ever, ever felt like this before in my whole entire life. It's just unbelievable how you can feel, one second you can feel so big, and then the next minute, nothing, like. On top of that, I walked in 2 seconds late. Big deal, Maria was late. I saw your face in a
crowded place. Thank you.
Everyone has suffered here today at Maria's school.
I don't think I'm good enough, and it's wrong. I just don't want to be here. Sorry.
But it's only going to get tougher, because tomorrow morning, 15 girls have to go.
So, who thinks they did enough to get through to sing at Lord and Lord Webber's house today so far? Very few of you, I can tell you. You need to up your game, up your ante, and really give it tomorrow. Your last chance. Right.
The 20 girls that survive Maria School will be invited to perform at Andrew's country estate. The chapel in his grounds has been converted into a theatre, and it's where Andrew tries out all his new ideas.
Every single show of mine, from Evita right up to The Woman in White, has premiered on that stage. It can sometimes be the toughest test.
They'll be faced with an audience of his close friends and industry bigwigs. And from there, Andrew will pick his 10 Marias. After that, well, it's all down to you. Day 2 at Maria School, and it's D-Day for 15 girls. As they struggle on under Zoe's harsh regime, David Ian is on his way. Due to Andrew's overwhelming work commitments, David is sent in as an official hatchet man. His task? To dash the West End dreams of 15 Maria hopefuls. Like Andrew, he's got millions of pounds riding on this project, and having recently snatched Andrew's title of most powerful man in British theatre, he's not afraid to flex his own brand of corporate muscle.
I want a girl who you can believe. She climbs a tree and scrapes her knee, her dress has got a tear.
Andrew, the big thing to me is that she's got to appeal to the public. In fairness, sometimes we producers go wrong where we choose something that we think's right in terms of, you know, the singing, the dancing and the acting. But for me, I'm going to be very, very focused on what's this public reaction that we're getting every week and are they going to come and see her?
In fact, over the past 20 years, the two boys haven't always seen eye to eye, and it's looking like Maria will be no different.
Sorry, Andrew, you've consistently said, you know, a tomboy, yeah, quirky, climbs a tree, scrapes a knee.
I have. But sadly, I'm not sure she was one of the 10 worst. She didn't hit me.
Climbs a tree and scrapes a knee is one of the keys to this character. Absolutely. You know, she's clearly a fit, feisty girl, Maria.
David brings with him a top RADA acting coach to put the girls through their paces. And although jet-lagged from the Tony Awards in New York, David's determined to make his mark.
That's crucial. I mean, as far as I'm concerned, this was the opportunity to change through school. And if you guys are telling me, you know what, David, nothing's happened, now I'm beginning to, you know, genuinely get concerned.
It's time to let the girls know what's what.
Well, as you know, I'm the producer of The Sound of Music, so one of the big concerns for me, quite clearly, is selling tickets. Maria is an incredibly feisty, interesting, complicated character. So the next part of the test is going to be very, very focused on your acting skills.
David's devised a simple test to see who's got what it takes to engage an audience. For the 15 least convincing, their West End dreams will immediately be over. The girls have to prepare a 30-second acting piece inspired by song lyrics which describe Maria's character.
I'll be honest, I've got a flibbity gibbet. What the hell is a flibbity gibbet?
Well, look over here, love. There's a room full of them.
I did like a theatre studies AS level, but otherwise I've had like no sort of real acting experience. You know, I've never been taught how to act or, you know, all that kind of stuff. So, you know, feeling a little bit out of my depth.
I just need time to create and to do everything. You know, I just want to be here and to do everything I have to do.
Hello. This whole improvisation thing has thrown us all, I think, into the deep end. And some of us are swimming and some of us are drowning.
Here comes 22-year-old Sam with her own unique interpretation of Maria.
Maria, she could throw a whirling dervish out of world. Sam,
become Maria.
A kite! Can you see it? The big red one?
Where?
How much would you just love to be a kite, just flying all day on nothing but air and air and stuff to make anybody dizzy?
Dizzy, yes.
You know, the best way...
Shoes off, really excellent, I'm loving it. Very good.
Feel it.
Yes.
It's free, it
hair nothing. Down, she's versatile.
Stay here all day.
Very good.
Okay, go on.
All right, next up, here's Rebecca with her own interpretation of one of the greatest stage and screen icons of all time.
Lovely, great. Listen, we better hurry up. Time is getting on.
Oh, Maria, no, do not do that. Rebecca Blonde.
Absolutely not.
I didn't mean to be late for the lesson, miss.
Thankfully, Essex shop assistant Leanne brings a little thespian class to the proceedings.
I saw the most beautiful bird, and it was singing the most beautiful melody. And I was just memorised.
Memorised, were you? Meanwhile, Andrew has to just let them get on with it, because he's far too busy with Evita.
It's very busy at the moment. It is unusual. You don't normally have a production opening on the west coast of America or in Las Vegas, and then one in London back to back. And it is a dreadful collision, actually. Evita will be the thing for me over the next 2-3 weeks, really.
Trumpet, a horn, isn't it?
We're just at that stage now with the Sound of Music programme where everybody's been allowed to get on and do it. They don't want me hanging around, sitting over their shoulder every 2 minutes.
Indeed they don't, because without Andrew there, they can take his precious Marias, like Kimberly, and lose 15 of them, entirely at their own discretion, in 1 hour's time.
Kimberly, become Maria.
Good afternoon, I'm so sorry I'm late.
I'm always falling down for it. My mummy says I'm such a close. Yesterday, me and my brother were climbing a tree, and I fell out of it.
Thank you very much indeed. Very good.
Somewhat understandably, David and Zoe are casting a keen eye over Andrew's saved girls. Lucy is next.
Thinner.
That's our posh lady,
that's
I remember.
With the tiara. Mm-hmm.
Lucy, become Maria.
Summer smell, summer air, the birds, the trees. This is where I belong, these oaks, this land.
Bizarre is the word, yeah. I think. Bizarre choice.
Thank you very much indeed.
Coming, Mother!
It's not Mother that's coming, Lucy. It's, yep, Andrew. Once again, the man who is used to scrutinising every aspect of every production just can't keep away. Back at Maria School, and blissfully unaware of the incoming maelstrom, David and Zoe prepare to put two more of Andrew's chosen ones through the ringer. Starting with Rhiann.
A will o' the wisp, a clap.
It's only the biggest thing in my career, but never mind. But I feel so nervous. You're not going to put me up against the wall and shoot me, are you, if I don't get the part?
So...
Andrew's unexpected arrival throws things into chaos. He wants to make sure that David and Zoe are clear on his vision for Maria.
That she's got to be clown, funny, a tomboy, climbs a tree, scrapes her knee. You've got to believe she can do all that.
I just want to run in the hills and be free as a bird with the flowers.
Now, this will put the cat amongst the pigeons.
Simona, would you please step forward?
I'm not going to allow the general to treat his own blessed children like that. That was cruel. You don't know me.
She's a great actress, but
the accent, I know.
Far from just standing at the back, Andrew's already had some thoughts.
Yeah, I mean, it's the thing, she's got to make us laugh. She's a clown,
maybe
too.
Maybe that's what somebody needs to ask her to do.
I'd like to see if she could do something which makes us laugh. And she's got to make us laugh, hasn't she?
Yeah. Maybe we need to discuss that with her after this, maybe. Yeah. If we like her.
There are only a few girls left to perform. Emily is next. And she was a real favourite of Andrew's when he saw her audition.
Sing hallelujah, come on, get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Sing hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day.
Oh, it's summer and yet the mountains are still snow-tipped. Oh, and oh, it's the children coming out to play. Oh, look at them playing their little games. Oh, I wish I could still play with them. Oh, no.
All along, Andrew has loved her voice, her distinctive look, but now her acting skills, well.
Oh, the nuns are going to have me do extra penance. Oh.
Okay, thank you very much indeed. Very nice.
Meanwhile, Bryony has arrived late after sitting an A-level. Not only has she missed vital classes, but she's had less time than the others to prepare.
Maria is I, as in ice cream. M, as in meadows. A, as in... Ah, the captain's coming!
As in, well, she's nailed flibbertigibbet.
T, as in turning.
Thank you very much indeed. That's okay.
That's okay.
Anyway,
stop.
Thank you.
It's decision time. 15 girls must leave today, and now they must nervously wait to see if it's their dream of West End stardom that's about to be shattered. David, Zoe, and their acting coach have a big decision to make.
I didn't think that this lady came back and showed us anything this time that I didn't see last time.
Not
I expected to see a lot of improvement there.
Andrew, for once, has decided he will adopt a hands-off approach.
So at this stage, you're holding back a little bit. You're kind of letting them...
Well, you know, they are on the ground. They've done the selection. And I'm just going to... I'm just watching.
You're just making sure no one falls through the net.
That's the general plan.
Now, look, Simona, I need to talk to you about her because I think she's fabulous. She acted, I thought, superbly, but she has a strong accent.
Please, help me. Help me to handle these little creatures.
Could you work with that? Could a voice coach, you know, work on that enough? Because I want to put her through.
I think a voice coach would have their work cut out for them.
I'd have to see evidence that that accent started to disappear.
Okay, can we just discuss, Miss Unfunny Comedy?
Are you Captain Von... Oh, you're not Captain Von Trapp. You don't look like him at all.
Because I'm not getting it, to be honest.
For me, it's the wrong part. It's zany comedian US TV type series. It's not. Yeah. It's
saying
not
that
this.
At the same time, it's a huge challenge for me vocally. I'd love to have a one-to-one on her and show her that she can actually sing these notes. She doesn't think she can.
The quality is lacking. I don't think that.
She's a no for me. It bugged me putting her through
no,
the first time.
No, don't. I want to have an hour.
Okay. Well, you're going to get one more cut. All she right. can go through to 40, okay, but if she goes through to 20, you're going to need to prove something.
Fair enough.
We've gone down to 40. Mm-hmm. The next stage is we need to cut down to 20. Now you get to the acting side, and I think there's probably half a dozen that could possibly even do it.
Mm. I think tops,
you
half
know,
a dozen.
And I pray that there's six who can sing it as well.
It's key.
I don't think there's that many people who can do this, and now I'm getting nervous.
After only 15 minutes, they decide which 15 girls must go. The girls are brought in to hear their fate. But, Andrew being Andrew, he's decided he does want to give a few notes after all.
Well, the one who disappointed me today was Emily. The look of her is absolutely right for us.
Yeah.
And I think she's... I mean,
the girls are kept waiting as Andrew dictates his notes.
She was the biggest disappointment today. Yeah. Okay. We've just got to get it back out of her.
Absolutely.
He gives some more notes.
But I mean, I'm sort of on the outside of this in one way, but I've heard so much from everybody else, and I thought her...
And then some final notes.
Was terrific. So we're really clear. I mean, keep the A-list acting-wise, A-list singing-wise, but it's going to be a tough day tomorrow, isn't it? Because we've got to get down to 20.
We've got to go from 40 to 20.
And we've got people who are favourites in both departments.
Absolutely. Okay. Yeah. We know what we're doing.
After 30 minutes, and with other work commitments screaming for his attention, Andrew has finally left, and David delivers the news. 15 girls are about to miss out on the chance of a lifetime.
There are some people in this room that we think can absolutely go all the way, and there are some that we don't. As I call out your name, I'd like you to step clearly one pace forward. Belinda Evans, Kirsty McCrudden, Emily Alford, Bryony Price, Emily Booth, and Megan Cassidy. Ladies, You could be Maria's. Please take a seat to the right. Connie Fisher. Shelley Andrew. Kimberly Bauer. You could all be Maria. Please take a seat. Lucy Rose. Simone Armstrong. If you have taken one step forward, it means that you could be Maria. Well done. Okay, final line. Lucy Garrioch. Samantha Kennedy. Tracy Lyle. If you're one of the three ladies standing in the front of this final row, I'm sorry, you are not Maria. But thank you for coming and thank you for auditioning. The other ladies, congratulations. You could be Maria.
Simona is through, but we'll have to convince them she can change her accent. Despite missing classes, Bryony managed to charm the judges with her acting. Siobhan's beauty guaranteed her place, but if she can't find her voice, she hasn't got a hope. Kirsty was saved again, this time by Zoe, but she's only hanging on by a thread.
Unbelievable. And Blue, I thought, like, she once called us forward, I thought, that's me out. Like, I couldn't. Oh, that's too much.
There are just 40 girls left. And the girls' next test tomorrow is going to be even more brutal. In only 24 hours' time, all the girls will have to sing for their professional lives as one by one they are silenced by David and Zoe. It's cruel. It's humiliating. It's a brutal reminder of the harsh world that show business really is. And at the end of this ordeal, only 20 of the girls will be left standing. Time is very much against everyone now. David leaves Zoe to push the final 40 through more intensive vocal training.
Now's the time when you've really got to up your ante, okay? Kirsty, yeah. You're a very lucky girl.
I know.
Right? Don't speak, just listen. I saved you for one reason and one reason only. Yesterday, I did some work with you vocally. You had no top range. You listened to what I said. You found your voice. Stand up. Be proud. You got through today. Okay? You're lucky.
Thanks, Beth.
You need to work hard. Bryony, you need to prove to me that you can find that pureness in your soprano voice. It's still not there for me. Zoe, you've got to prove to me that you can breathe like a singer. Okay? The rest of you, well done. Okay? Great. There's some strong singers in this room.
Romanian Simona is next on Zoe's hit list.
Okay, I want you to sing. Say don't.
Don't.
Cry.
Cry.
For.
For.
Me.
Me. Me.
Me.
Me.
Argentina.
Argentina.
Good. Simona can't speak English very well at all, and it's reflecting in her lyrics. English. English.
Don't cry for me, Argentina.
I call this problem with truth. My husband said to me, he says, please truth all the time.
Don't cry for me, Argentina. The truth is I never left you.
We don't say ever, say never.
I never left you. I never left you.
Yeah. I know it's a huge problem for everybody else, and I am praying that she sorts it out, because nobody in Maria School right now has as much passion and spirit as Simona. Thank you.
I was probably better last night, but now I'm really worried because
She didn't mention anything else, any problems, but she said, "Lady, I need your English to be right."
Elsewhere at Maria School, 21-year-old Emily has a different struggle on her hands. Like over half the girls here, she studied at a prestigious music academy, leaving her voice superb, but unfortunately everything else way off the mark.
Sexy.
You've got lots of sort of girly girls and lots of very sort of graceful people, and you know, you kind of get a bit hung up on that in the sense that I have two left feet, no coordination and no dance training, and I'm just sort of, you know, sort of falling about everywhere and don't really know what I'm doing, and everyone's dancing a West Side Story and I'm just going...
Time is also running out for Golden Girl Siobhan. She has to find her voice before tomorrow or she doesn't stand a chance.
My voice is just so limited. I mean, it's horrible. It's actually really making me so upset because I've always had, like, quite a high register and everything is so... it's come so easily. And now it's like I go and hit a note and all I hear is, like, oh, and nothing comes out. So it's quite depressing, to be honest. There are so many more people there that are better than me, who have better voices than me, and it's like I can't put forward my best asset because I physically can't sing. Do you know what I mean?
Kirsty, however, is making marked improvements.
She listened to me, perhaps for the first time, did what I asked her to do, technique-wise, and found her voice.
Okay, stop.
Okay, not to maybe a higher standard as some of the other girls, but she can do it, and as a teacher, that's what it's all about. And I'm really happy for her. That's why I kept her in.
But time is limited. Tomorrow morning, the girls are going to face their hardest challenge yet.
They've got another test coming up, and then they need to sing like they've never sung before.
One by one, they will be picked off until only 20 remain. Tonight is going to be a long, tense night for everyone, including Andrew. For tonight in London, it's the opening night of Andrew's new production of Evita.
I've got, you know, 100 people from all over the world who want to talk to me tonight. It's a thrill for me, but the greatest thrill for me is when you know a girl's walked on stage and she's absolutely taken the house.
Andrew is happy with this leading lady, but as he charms his way through tonight's media circus, he's painfully aware that tomorrow, David will be choosing the final 20 Marias, and Andrew just has to trust him to get it right. Dawn the next morning. The day of reckoning.
And so, the final test. In an effort to prove they can fill the biggest role in show business, our 40 remaining Marias must prove they can fill this space.
It's exactly the same size as the stage at the London Palladium. Only the 20 girls who can impress on this scale will be good enough to go on and perform at Andrew Lloyd Webber's country estate. David's given the girls 2 hours to prepare a performance of the title song from The Sound of Music. As they perform, he'll then throw 20 of them out and they'll be gone. Permanently.
Bryony in herself, she worries about the breathing, and Bryony worries about the breathiness, and she worries a bit about what Zoe will think, I guess. But Maria doesn't. She just does it, doesn't she?
This song's really important to us, to hear the girls sing, because it's going to show us technically how much they've taken in and how much they've learnt or how much they've changed over the last 2 days. And it's quite tough technically because it sits in the part of the voice, which is quite hard for some of the girls. So I know they're panicking, but also apart from the singing, we need to see them believe that they are Maria today.
My belly's practicing and going mad. I need as much space as what I can get. Like. So I can try, I can keep on trying, but don't know if trying's going to be good enough.
Like a astonishingly, novice performer Leanne has never had a singing lesson in her life. Unfortunately, though, neither was gravelly toned Zoe.
Like a lark who is learning to break.
I've never sung high in my life. I just don't ever get to sing high. I've never had to.
With songs they have sung for 1,000 years.
there's a distinct split developing at Maria School. Because for those girls that have had previous vocal training, this test is set to be a walk in the park.
The hills are alive with the sound of music, with songs they have sung.
If they don't want me for the part, then, well, so, you know, I mean, I'll get another part or something. I'll do something else.
I spend my 9-to-5 job waiting for the next audition to prove myself to be good enough. And I'm sick of being the bridesmaid, you know? So, but that's the way the business is, you know? I want this part more than anything.
Zoe's ready. David's ready. Girls are taking their places. And as they prepare for their biggest test yet... Oh, look. Guess who's arrived with a couple of last-minute notes. Andrew simply can't resist a flying visit just to make sure everything is in order.
Can we just discuss one more time for me? Because there's just one concern, which is her. Did you like her?
Yeah, I did. Yes, I did. I
think because vocally she wasn't that strong right now.
It wasn't today, but I have heard her do very well.
And we're all solid on her over her? Yes.
Yes.
I think we're there.
Having made it perfectly clear who he likes, Andrew leaves David to pick up the cards and hopefully make his own perfect choice.
That is the right decision.
It's so hard.
Pressure is on for David and Zoe to make exactly the right selection. Each girl will have to be note perfect to impress them at this stage. They cannot stop singing until David taps them on their shoulder. For 20 girls, that means the end of the road to West End stardom.
A brilliant time.
I'm so sorry it's come to an end now. That's...
Don't worry about it. This is life. This is what happens. I'm fine.
My heart will be blessed with the sound of music, and I'll
honestly, just build so much confidence from this. Know what a good singer you are now. Yeah?
Never sang in my life before. That's like odd.
Don't let this knock you or defeat you.
With Kirsty gone, only 3 of Andrew's 4 redrafted girls remain. Then 2, as Lucy, the second of his favourites, is next to fall.
Baby.
I'm good. How are you?
Are you all right?
It was nice just singing all together. I thought, well, there'll be no more pink in this competition now. She's gone.
We're out of pink. Well, there'll be a little more. there are some Maria t-shirts left.
I know.
And we'll remember you every time we see a Maria t-shirt.
Oh, bless you.
Honestly, you've been a ray of sunshine the whole way through.
10 girls have already had their dreams crushed. And 10 more are about to suffer the same fate. And there goes the third of Andrew's choices. It's been a Maria massacre. There are 22 girls left singing. Another two have to go. Will it be sweet, sweet Bryony? Not this time.
Ladies, thank you very, very much. If you are still in this room, you are going to Sidmonton, to Andrew Lloyd Webber's house, and certainly I can say without any doubt that one out of the 20 of you is Maria. Well done.
Well done, guys. Well done, you guys.
No, I actually can't. I was like,
oh, baby, don't cry. Be happy.
I'm so happy.
So, wait, if you'd have said to me at the very, very beginning, would these necessarily be here? I'd say some of them definitely not, but the improvement and the journey that they've made has been massive.
And it's just a relentlessly cruel process.
it's the only process we've got.
No, I know, and it never gets better. No.
If they want a career in the West End musicals, you know what? You don't even get a phone call in the West End. If you're down to the final two, if it's not you, you don't even get told. So this is a lot kinder, believe me.
You should let them enjoy this moment.
Absolutely. This is the good bit. This is lovely.
Still in with a chance are experienced performers Connie, Helena, and despite worries about her accent, Romanian actress Simona. Leanne, who taught herself to sing from CDs at home. Kimberly is the last of Andrew's saved girls to survive. And Bryony, the girl who thinks she should be Maria because she fancies Christopher Plummer. She's still on her way to the biggest role in showbiz. David has selected his top 20 for Sidmonton, but will Andrew agree? Later tonight, 20 will become 10 when they have to sing for survival in Andrew Lloyd Webber's private theatre to one of the toughest audiences in show business. The next morning, the girls are en route to Andrew's country home. In a matter of hours, they'll have to give the performance of their life. Only 10 will be good enough for Andrew to put through and face your vote next week. Ultimately, only one of them will win the dream part of Maria von Trapp. Girls have arrived at the Lloyd Webber Country Pile.
See, I'm now familiar with Andrew Lloyd Webber's work, so I know all the words. Jesus Christ, superstar!
Oh, look, horsey,
jersey. Still can't see the house yet. We've driven like 5 miles up the drive.
Barely enough to walk in.
This will be the first time Andrew has let a group of unknowns perform at his home, let alone on stage in his private theatre. With 50 of the most important faces in the world of show business as their audience, the girls have a lot to live up to. And with millions invested and his reputation on the line, Andrew also has a lot to lose. This will be his first chance to view the final 20 girls that David and Zoe have deemed up to the challenge.
Welcome to Sidmonton. And as it's so hot, what I tell you what I'm going to do is I'm going to take you over to the pool. So why don't you come with me? Let's go. Even though you may not believe it, every single one of my shows has started here from Evita onwards. Everything, The Phantom was done there. We even did Starlight Express, which you probably really don't believe. So you're not following very much.
Oh, no.
No, just easy. It'd just be another wonderful cast for us. So, I think down to the pool, come on, let's go. You go down that way.
Is there a slide?
The girls put their nerves to one side and briefly enjoy all the trappings of their own private pool house. But the fun doesn't last long. It's the first time Andrew's been able to take a close personal look at David's choices. And with only a few hours before they are due to go on stage and face his specially invited celebrity audience, he summons the girls in groups to join him for a face-to-face meeting. And as if they don't have enough to do, he pulls them out of rehearsals to do it. He has serious issues with some of the girls. Operatic Emily is first in the firing line.
Everybody thought, including myself when I saw you, that you were one of our very strongest candidates.
And since then it's kind of gone downhill.
Since then it's kind of gone, not exactly downhill, but perhaps hasn't gone as far uphill as we'd like.
Yeah.
I think you maybe you've let yourself down a little bit, and I think, you know, over the next day, it's really important to come up that notch.
Yeah.
I really do.
Three, four.
Don't Emily is no fan of criticism.
You went to Andrew. You didn't go to Andrew.
No, I went to Andrew.
Right, and what did you have to say? Because I'm just sort of sensing some upset.
No, it's fine. No. He just said he was disappointed in my performance, that there was a general feeling of disappointment.
Yeah, we knew as soon as we got you to sing something classical that you have a great classical voice.
Oh yeah, but
and that's
like,
not that.
It's
no,
because
but you know
I can't
what it
bridge.
Is. I know. But what it is you've always got an answer, and at the moment it's appearing that you're just not taking it. You just think you go in and you're just like, well, look, this, and because of that, and it's because of this, and because of that. You know, we just sometimes it's better to be a little bit humble, and it does appear sometimes.
So you're saying that I'm like. That I'm stuck up or vain or
no,
whatever.
No, you just need to just chill about
you're
it. Just,
and she's under a lot of pressure.
Everybody's
of
under a lot of pressure.
She wasn't taking a note. She wasn't accepting when she was told she was doing something wrong. There was always an excuse. And this, oh, it's because of that. And my singing teacher at home, and my musical director at home. No, you're here. You're here to learn. You do what we tell you to do.
He loved you in the audition. And it has been a case of, you know, get her to do this, get her to do
so
that.
So he's disappointed, like, with my attitude?
He was disappointed yesterday, I think, when you sang, and some of the footage that you've seen before, just vocally, that's all.
Yeah, because, oh, gosh.
But don't take, he's, you know,
it's
did
like
he not
there's
say
a reason something? For that I prefer to not talk on camera about, you know what I mean?
A reason for what? Okay, a reason for what?
She feels that Andrew is personally picking on her right now. That's what's upset her most. And also that she spent last night teaching all the girls the harmonies, and that's why she doesn't know her own.
Don't bother teaching anybody else, okay?
Yeah.
Learn your f***ing own.
I don't need it thrust in my face. There's other girls here that can't read music like you, but are more humble and have a less in-your-face attitude. And it's not attractive right now.
Look, I don't want you to say this, but can you bugger off for like 5 seconds while I go off and have a little bit of Emily time?
Next under the cosh is Bryony.
Bryony, what makes you think you could be Maria when you're so young?
I'd give you a package deal where I'd combine everything that was important.
And do you really feel that you could be a West End star at your age? Really?
I don't think the age matters. It's what's, you know, I think I'll be the same at any age, really. I mean, a bit,
you maybe, might be a bit stronger. Anyway, do your best. I know you will.
I will try.
Punching the air.
Okay.
Meanwhile, with just one night to go before their showcase, choreographer Craig has been drafted in to make it stage-worthy. He has a tough job ahead, as some of the girls haven't appeared on stage before.
It's my fault.
Nothing should be moving except your lips. And we should see the spray coming out of your mouth. Try it again.
You better have done it. They abused it. I bet you what I've done was wrong.
Good.
Laura, well, tell us what you do for a living.
I'm an intelligence officer for Thames Valley Police.
You know, a job like that, how can you just give that up to go into the theatre?
This is my dream. This is what I've always wanted to do. And I wouldn't hesitate, to be honest, to leave.
Anyway, good luck tomorrow. Siobhan, how are you feeling? You sound a bit sort of croaky and poorly still.
Well...
Anyway, so why do you think you could be a great Maria for us?
Ever since a child, it's been obviously my all-time favourite musical. I associate with the part of Maria because I feel I'm in a similar sort of part in my life as well, trying to find out what I'm good at, where I belong.
And I hope you feel better. Thank you. The one thing, of course, we haven't been able to really do this week is to assess how your voice really is. But you're here.
Yes.
And have a good early night is my advice.
Each girl will be expected to perform a group number and a solo, and Zoe isn't happy with their progress.
What are you singing? Do we only need to start again on all this? I can't believe that we have to start.
It's really only me and Lauren putting that in.
The problem is they can sing it really well, but they need to do it with the moves.
Yeah, well, at the same time.
I know, but make them do it with the harmonies and the moves. Thank you. Because every time they do the movement, they lose the harmony.
Okay, girls.
With just hours till curtain up, Zoe gives the girls a pep talk, like only Zoe knows how.
Okay, this is where it really gets tough. Okay, this is where it really, really gets tough. I don't want attitude, I don't want negativity, I don't want insecurity, I don't want paranoia, I'm not interested.
Later tonight, they will have to perform.
Now, Andrew, your private performances that you put on here at Tiverton, they have a really high reputation. 20 Marias performing for your invited guests. How are you feeling?
Quite nervous. You see, some of them who I thought were bankers have been a bit like that today.
Presumably you have never had, say, a Leanne here before. Leanne, who's never had a day's training. She's taught herself from CDs.
It's extraordinary. I mean, I sometimes think to myself, what am I doing when we've had, you know, people right at the top of their profession here, you know? And then we got this little kid who's absolutely, completely self-taught.
Are you at all suspicious that some of your invited guests are coming to just see a disaster?
Of course.
Why do you think people want you not to find, like to say it isn't possible to find a Maria in this way?
Because I think we're doing something completely new. We're not auditioning through the normal process. We're actually going completely the other way around, saying, look, we found 20 girls, we think that we've got the confidence to put them on in something, we've got somebody in to stage them. And as you say, I mean, one of them has done absolutely nothing at all, and most of them have done practically nothing. I mean, this could be the biggest, biggest train crash you've ever seen in your life. I mean, this could be the biggest, biggest train crash you've ever seen in your life.
Join us tonight when it's showtime for the girls.
My nerves are now kicking in because I don't really know what to expect.
Oh, it's Michael Winner and some woman.
Celebrities and critics prepare themselves for the worst. David and Andrew nearly come to blows over who goes through.
Climbs a tree and scrapes her knees, one of the keys to his character. You know, she's clearly a fit, feisty girl, Maria.
But I think we all agree that.
Fine.
Which girls will get through to the final 10? And will Andrew ever be able to solve a problem like Maria?